My name's Catherine Speechley, and I was one of the volunteers in the Discovering Lives project, which looked at the lives and the work of the Red Cross nurses in Chepstow Hospital during the First World War. And one of the ladies that I looked at was Ellen Anstruther Griffiths. And so this is a little bit about her. Ellen was born in 1860 in Aldgate, London. Her father, James Griffiths, was part of a large family in Chepstow. And in London, he was working as a mercantile clerk. In 1857, he married Isabella, the daughter of a master mariner. Ellen was their second child. A son, Arthur John, later known as John, was born 2 years earlier. During the 1860s, however, the family seems to have fallen apart. By the 1871 census, Ellen, now 11, is living in Chepstow with her uncle, Thomas Griffiths, and his family. Isabella is recorded as being a widow, and we couldn't find any trace of what had happened to John. However, from this difficult start, Ellen's fortune seemed to have improved greatly. She progressed through teacher training to various teaching posts at the Board School in Chepstow, eventually becoming head teacher at the renamed Chepstow Girls Council School. In addition to these duties, she took over the running of her uncle's business, stationery and bookseller's shop in Beaufort Square, after her uncle and his second wife died. In 1912, she joined the Red Cross, together with her employees, Amy Woodley and Eleanor Guilfoyle, who lived with her above the shop in Beaufort Square. And so when war broke out in 1914, she was one of the first to volunteer for duty at the Red Cross Hospital in Chepstow. Since she was still head of girls' school, her work was part-time at the hospital. However, she encouraged her pupils to contribute to the well-being and the running of the hospital. They made needlework items such as tea cloths and dusters, and knitted socks for the men there. Helped with catering, even peeling potatoes on Christmas Day, and weeding the garden. In 1915, the pupils gave a concert in the hospital grounds, and the school was used by the soldiers for a fundraising event of their own. Ellen retired from teaching in 1924, but continued to run the stationery business. She never remarried and died in 1944, having spent the majority of her years actively involved in Chepstow life.